Look at that beauty. Mike Czerny custom clip point trapper. Look at these stag covers. Look how gnarly they are. The color, everything is just gorgeous in this knife. This is everything a custom slip joint should be. Just gorgeous. Of course, I probably shouldn't have to explain this, but possibly some people may not know. There's no gaps in here. There's actually, well, we're going to get into that. Check out the fit and finish. Absolutely no gaps. Look at this nice deep fluting on the bolsters. Everything's just dead even, dead flush when it's closed. Excuse me, we're fighting off some sickness in the house. Check out that shield. Everything is inlaid in there perfectly, no gaps. Again, custom slip joint should not have any gaps in it. All the pins, just beautifully done. Love that gnarly cover. See how deep some of these stag marks. So much character. Really nice clip point blade, hand rub satin finish. Just absolutely stunning in real life here. Check out how that swedge comes down, just accentuates the lines of that nicely done clip point blade. It's really, really something to see here. Grinds all dead on. You can see how that swedge comes down, both plunge lines on the same side. Gorgeous. See that nail neck? Really nice and defined. Really, really thin blade. This knife, if I'm not mistaken, is CTS. Not CTS. This is CPM 154. So it's a nice stainless blade. Has a real fine particle grain. Can get really sharp. And responds well to a strop. So really, if you wanted to use this knife, sharpen up real quick. And certainly this knife could take it. I'm only saying that because of the cost of something like this. This is probably not well over, but probably over $1,000 knife. So not quite sure if you'd want to throw in your pocket and use it. I know you certainly could. The fit and finish is just amazing. If this were my knife, I don't know if I could use it. I don't know if I'd want to mess up that hand-done satin blade. I know the owner uses it, though. So anyways, check out, when you do this fluting, do you know how hard it is to keep everything absolutely perfect? So this, you see that little line right here? Everything is the exact same. This distance from here to here is the same from here to here. When you're doing that by hand with a file, and then make everything perfect and symmetrical on both sides, that's really incredible. You cannot see any pin in the bolster here at all. It's a nice, gorgeous polish. And there you can see his maker's mark, Mike Czerny. He makes a lot of like art knives that are like liner locks. He makes some flippers. He makes some pretty radical traditional knives with some pocket clips on them and stuff. I believe the Wieners and Steel guys went to Blade Show and showed off some of his other knives. So that can be found on YouTube. Terra Fanatic. That's his name. Check out his channel. They got a good thing going over there. Nice half stop. Really, really gorgeous action. Nice and flush on the half stop. Nice and flush closed. And I know you guys seen that nice and flush when it was open. Let's check out how seamless it is. Walk and talk is incredible. So if I'm not mistaken, the owner told me that this knife actually has milled out. So this was a nice thick piece of metal down here. See, as thick as these bolsters are. Let's close this up so I don't get cut. It's extremely sharp. So you can see at its thickest point how thick this is. So this knife on each side started off this thick, and then it's been milled down, or somehow material's been removed here. I don't know if it was a manual mill or CNC. I don't think he's using CNC. But anyways, this material has been removed to allow for the cover to sit in place. Again, there's no gaps here. But it makes for a stronger knife. It makes for a cleaner look when you can't see any line right here where the liner matches up against the bolster, because it's all one piece. See that? And you really can't even see where the spring comes down to meet the liners on the side. So this all looks like one piece of steel coming all the way down. But it's not. Yeah, you can see the liner right there. Kinda, maybe. Yeah, all right there. Which is not a flaw in fit and finish, because that spring has to move. It needs to rise up to allow for the blade to open, right? And that's what locks it open, or you know what I mean? Kind of gives it that stiff action to stay open. Incredible. Absolutely incredible. What a package. Mike Czerny clip point trapper. Fits in your hand. Awesome. Has so much grip due to this nice gnarly stag on here. Absolutely stunning. Really don't want to send this one back, but I have to. Even the inside of the knife looks like it's mirror polished on the inside there. If it's not, it's a real high satin. Incredible. So check them out if you are into traditional knives and you want to spend the dough on one. I think it's worth it. There's certainly a lot of work that comes to get this good. I know some people may think that custom slip joints might be a little bit easy or easier to make than a standard modern one-handed old opener or a flipper or something like that. But from what I've heard, it is the hardest knife to make. Especially when you consider all the pivot geometry and everything that goes into making that spring flush when it's closed, when it's in the half stop, and when it's open, right? Because if the back of the tang is off just a little bit, it's not going to sit flush in that half stop, right? If that was just a little bit shorter, that blade, the spring here, would sink down onto the blade and it wouldn't be flush in the half stop. So to get that figured out, and then get the kick figured out on the blade here that hits up against the blade, and also the tension that's on this underside of the tang, the tension that that has pushing up against the kick to let that sit flush on the top, and then also, you know, because you can't change the shape, this is not a shape-shifting metal here, it's figured out the exact perfect length so that it's also dead flush when it's open. It's an incredible amount of work. And finishing. Because, yeah, you can cheat when it's open. And you could sand this down and make it even. But when it closes, you may not get that flush. And you know, when it's closed. And certainly, you see on a lot of knives, a lot of production knives, you don't see that flush when it's in that half stop. Because there's just so many variables that happen there. So when you see that in the action, and then you feel that it has no blade play, absolutely nothing side to side, nice, crisp. It's a solid, solid walk on this. So it's about an 8 pull, maybe 7.5. It's not a nail breaker by any means, but it's nice and stiff. It's gorgeous. A lot of work goes into this. Feels really nice in your hand, nice and contoured. The covers match, nice and matching. What I mean is it looks like it was off the same piece. Of course, a natural material like this is going to be a little bit different, but there shouldn't be a huge thickness difference. You see some stag-handled production knives, they're real thick on one side, real thin on one side, you know. But not the case with this little guy here. It's gorgeous. So anyways, I'm going to stop gushing over this knife, and I'm going to show you the next one. I do appreciate you guys checking out my video. Tons more. Just stay tuned, guys. Thank you so much.